Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to change all design cell names in a layout using Calibre Layout Filemerge. Changing all the cell names in a file can be useful if you want to share the layout, but you don't want to share all the cell names in the file. Here I've loaded a layout file, and I can see all the cell names that I want to change. And so my first step is to create a cell map file, and I'll do that interactively with a Tickle script. So the output of this script will be this cellmap.txt file. I'll set a counter. And then for each cell name in the list of cells in my layout, I'll map the source cell name to just a prefix cell underscore, and then I'll add my counter at the end. Last, I'll increment the counter, and then I'll close the output file. And I'll take a quick look at the cellmap.txt file. We can see the mapping from and to cell names. Next, I'll bring up the Filemerge export GUI. And here I'll select the source file and open the options. And I'm going to choose the cell map, and I'll put my cellmap.txt file name here. Then I'll click the Run Merge button. And when that completes, then I'll go back to the DesignRev GUI and open up the merge.gds file. And you can see in the cell list, all the cell names have been changed. It's also useful to be able to export only specific layers. You can do that with Filemerge. So here I'm showing just the layer 108, a boundary layer. And so I'll open up the Filemerge GUI again and choose the option to only export these layers, and I'll type in 108.0, and I hit Run Merge, Overwrite. And now when that finishes, I'm going to save the command. I'm going to give it a name so that I can run this outside of the GUI. So call it run underscore fm.tickle. Close. And now I'll reload this layout. And you can see that only layer 108 was loaded. Next, we'll take a quick look at this run script we created. And these are the options we use for Filemerge. Go ahead and exit. And we'll run that from the command line, Calibre DRV and script name. And here we just ran the same script in batch mode. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.